Good morning, guys. Thank you for joining me. Last night at 9:47 Pacific Standard Time, I believe 10:47 p.m. last night there in Nevada, 11:47 p.m. Central Daylight Time, there was a magnitude 4.6 earthquake that actually recorded all the way up to the Yellowstone volcano caldera. These are three of the closest monitors that I could find that were in Mina, Nevada, of that 4.6 earthquake. It was actually 4.69. 25 people reportedly felt this earthquake, and it was along the Walker Lane. It is what's called a thrust earthquake, one of the most deadliest, strongest earthquakes possible. Using Google Earth, here's location of that 4.6. It looks like what's happening of late is the Walker Lane is divided up in this area into two fault zones. And this is the area where they have a magnitude 6, I believe it was. Yeah, 6.0. Now that was on the 22nd of August of this year. And you can see how these earthquakes, let me bring it out. Yeah, they were going up along here by Colville. And then these more recent earthquakes are going up along another strand. This is all part of the Walker Lane. Walker Lane has been very active lately. The Walker Lane fault zone will be one day the dominant fault zone when the San Andreas probably ends up falling into the ocean. The recent earthquakes that have been going on, 2 years, maybe three, down there by Ridgecrest, is also part of the Walker Lane. So I mapped out the location of the earthquakes in the last 24 hours on this strand of the Walker Lane fault zone. And many of them are thrust earthquakes. And there's a couple that are strike slip, because as you know, earthquakes will trigger earthquakes along other fault zones. And we have some that go from east to west, but the Walker Lane goes from north, kind of southwest. I don't have the fault zones entirely mapped out, but up over here, there we go. Let me bring this out. This is what's called the Smith Valley fault zone. And it's all part of the Walker Lane. But it looks like, if you zoom in, it looks like it makes a little jag to the northeast. And it probably joins up with that, even though I don't have it drawn out. In the past 24 hours, there's been 92 earthquakes on this map. 92. There has been a lot going on along this area. Yeah, you know, I've talked about the earthquakes up there by Reno. Over here you can see Walker Lake. And I talked about the Juan de Fuca plate, how it's subducting underneath the lake here, Lake Tahoe, and all the earthquakes that that's been causing. Interesting too, the Walker Lane actually goes all the way up. You can see the fault line here. And then let me bring it out to the Juan de Fuca fault line. It actually joins up with the Mendocino Triple Junction. Like I said, eventually the San Andreas fault will be no more. All that will have moved north, the area of California. And probably a lot of it be falling into the ocean and no more. They'll have beachfront property there in Nevada. But anyways, yeah, the Walker Lane curves up and goes around here to the Mendocino Triple Junction. And we have the Juan de Fuca area, the plate here, which is subducting. And the southern end of that is extending all the way down here to Lake Tahoe, to the Walker Lane fault zone. Another thing that's very interesting. Let me zoom back in and I'm going to show you. Okay, there's all the earthquakes. Well, not all of them, but a majority of them. Over here on the west, we have an ancient volcano. We got the Epithets Pass. It's a stratovolcano. And you guys know that there's all kinds of magma flows, lava fields, all the way up there to Reno, Nevada. I've talked about, and I circled out in yellow some of the past cinder cones that are still standing. Uplift that's currently going on as the subduction of the Juan de Fuca plate goes underneath this area of Lake Tahoe. And let me go back to where those recent earthquakes are. Not far from here. Right there. You often have volcanoes where tectonic plates collide and subside. The whole ring of fire. So we have 95 right now listed here in the last 24 hours. Let's just zoom into where these swarms are happening. Most recent is a 1.3 at 12:31 universal time. So going to the monitor right here, this is what it's showing now. I don't have all the data pulled. Let's see, this one here is at what time? 12:52, so they don't have that one reported. And we got this one here at 12:51. I only have files pulled until what? 11:30. Let's see. 11:47. Yeah, look at the line of melt there. And then I want to make this bigger too. Let's go to its signature. Hold on. Harmonic tremors. Yeah. Let's look at the spectrogram. Not too bad at this monitor. Yeah, I hate that. But look at the line of melt. There's a small earthquake in there. Let's see. Let me pull it over a little bit. Got another one right there. At 11:29. Yeah, these earthquakes are coming in so fast, it's almost impossible for me to keep up. Now, these monitors, I want to show you, they're kind of a distance away from where all this activity is happening. They're from Mina, Nevada. Let me bring this out. All right, they're over here. Okay, here's where we're having the earthquakes. And this is where the three stations are at that I could find. I'm sure there's some closer, but I haven't been able to find them yet. And even all the way over there, see, it's picking up the signature of harmonic tremors. Yeah, interesting. So that's all I have for you right now. Any thoughts or comments or questions, please put it down below. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for your support. Make sure you're still subscribed. And don't forget to post a hello, hey, hi there. Because if you don't, USGS loves to unsubscribe people. Yeah, like I said, this Walker Lane here, it looks like it's got a fork. Where we got two different directions, and these are majority of them thrust earthquakes, which is triggering other earthquakes, and those other earthquakes are from right to left. You can see the fault lines through here. See, there's one there. That was a thrust. This was a strike slip, and you can you see that little line? And this other one was a strike slip earthquake, and you can see the fault line there too. So anyways, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for something much larger. And yeah, they're still pretty big, from that 6.0 they had a month ago. Once again, thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all.